pathway just said this is like getting the last touch of the flu out of your system. We just had a couple that we didn't come out on the right end of it. And to get one today where we did, it feels good. One more game now before we get back to getting the league play. So we're hoping we can finish this non-conference schedule off the right way. But I thought our guys played well today. Thought we played hard. Thought we had toughness about us at both ends. We always share the ball, so it's not surprising to me that we had 20 assists and 30 field goals because we just do it. Manage the ball at time we play. But of course the obvious things that jump out are Juan'ya getting the triple double, and of course Ameen was the benefactor of a lot of those passes. So, but good way, a lot of contributions from a lot of people, and so here we go.
Career high today. You broke by 2 points to the career high you set back in December 2nd. Your thoughts on doing, especially in this building and this festival today?
Well, I'm just excited. My first time in the game. Maybe it's going to be a game, so my journey is more. I feel good.
I mean, your 3-point shooting obviously has been fantastic all season. Has it been that way your whole career, or is this like, are you getting a new level this year?
I think I've been shooting both K while college, but I haven't been shooting this well. But I think my system would be like working at the practice pit and make the shot up a lot.
All right, Juan'ya, I feel like you've been chasing triple-double every game. How's the field finally get it? You finally did it, and pretty much how did you feel with your overall forward game?
I just say it's about time. Work hard and, working on both ends and grabbing the boards and trying to get my teammates involved, so I'm just glad I got it and got the game.
Coach, you told us before the game that everything you work on practice, shoring up the defense and making sure that you guys didn't have the same sort of problems, I guess you could say, that you had against Columbia and against LaSalle. What did you do differently as soon as the game started?
I thought you guys were asking about a 3-point shooting again because you asked me every game whether we shoot 14 or 27. I think you can ask these guys. We had two spirited practices. There was not a lot of laughing going on the last 2 days. So we really got after it. These guys responded, and everybody got the message. And we did pay attention to details more, and I think we showed.
Well, Juan'ya, how would you describe the improvement in Ameen, after the redshirt year last year, as from then?
My anchor is now. This is a big improvement to lead. In the offseason that you worked on it so much, you just got better at it. So I'm glad he's playing good and being efficient.
Kind of took my question, but for either of you guys, you had a long time off. Do you just feel like you're getting into it now at this point in the season, or you feel like you're at 100% before? After the year off?
Oh, after the year off, yeah. I feel like, them two scrimmages we had, they really prepared us for like the first game of the season playing against Penn State, St. Jude's, how they feel with us and how they got us back and got the rest off us. That helped us a lot.
Totally sure against Penn State.
I'm like, 100%. So that really helped me. We get in the gym more.
So for you, two guys, Juan'ya and Ameen, that come both for you from Niagara, that sit out all last year. What does it mean when you get to come here to play with them at the Barclays Center, see Juan'ya put up a triple-double, a career high for him. I mean, as good as you as it does, I'm sure, with them.
That's why we do what we do, just to have moments like this. And we talk about those 62 hours, 31 games. It's sacred time. We remind these guys about that, how it's going to go fast, and how you got to cherish the moment and so forth. And these guys do it. They do it every day. But, I'm not going to lie. I like being with these guys in practice, whether it was the Barclays Center or on our home floor for practice. It's a pleasure, and I'm lucky to be with you guys.
John, I know you still have one more game of board conference, but when you have a team that's shooting this well consistently from 3-point range, I mean, how valuable is that going to be when you get into conference play and people are playing zone?
I'll tell you what, we're anxious to get our big guy back too. I mean, that's what we're going to need to kind of. Yeah, I mean, it's something we do well. We're certainly not going to get away from things that we do well. But hopefully we can continue to do this and find ways to get shots for these guys because people are going to adjust.
Last question. Coach, what is, I think, you think the biggest lesson that you're going to take as you head into the conference play that you could take from the non-conference schedule?
Well, you know, I've said this before. I mean, we get 13 non-conference games, and each and every one of them serves a purpose. You know, this one was just a fantastic opportunity to play in a beautiful arena against another New York City team, which was exciting. You know, we want to play all the New York City teams because I think it's great to do that. You know, and then whether it's, I've said before, Columbia plays like William and Mary, and, you know, going through the schedule that way. So there's a lot of things we can take from the non-conference schedule. We've got to take a little bit.